Topics belongs to ray optics, that is nothing but a refraction at a spherical surface. You know, whenever there is refraction occurs, the medium change. So there will be two refractive index. In case of reflection, there is only one medium. That is the basic difference. Then second, here while we are dealing with this refraction at spherical surface, even reflection also, we need to consider what is image distance and object distance. Fine. And here extra is your radius of curvature. Okay. Considering these points, first I will tell you the important things which you need to apply for the derivation. First you will go through that three important points, then it will be very easy. Like this only you will start to enjoy. So let's start. See, this is nothing but your spherical surface. Then what you are going to do? This is nothing but your medium N1 index, refractive index. This is your refractive index, medium N2. Means from this surface, spherical surface, this side it is N1. This spherical surface outside, this is N2. This is N1, this is N2. Now suppose this is the center C. That is nothing but center of curvature or radius of curvature. What it is called as? This is nothing but, if you measure with respect to here, this is your radius of curvature. Clear? Now what you do? Allow your incident light to fall on it. What you are going to do? Allow your incident light to fall on it. So when you allow your incident light to fall on it, this is nothing but your incident light. Now just extend your radius of curvature to that point, same point. What is this angle? Is nothing but angle of incidence. Now when the your incident angle will strike the your surface, then there will be a refraction. So what will happen? Now it will start to, so this is nothing but your angle of a refraction. You can give this point name as M, and you can draw one perpendicular, call it as N. This is your object. This is nothing but your image is formed. Clear about it? This diagram you need to draw it. Okay. Now I told you three important points you need to remember, or you have already studied. Just I am reminding you. What are those three concepts important? First thing is that your Snell's law. So Snell's law, what it is? N1 sin I equal to N2 sin I. Clear? This is your Snell's law. Then second is, if your angle theta is very very small, then in such a case your sin theta becomes theta, tan theta becomes also approximately equal to theta. Second concept. Coming to third one, if you are considering a triangle, let this is be a triangle, ABC. So if you extend this line, this angle is nothing but called as exterior angle. These two angles is nothing but called as interior angle. Let it be I1, let it be I2. So you know your net exterior angle E equal to the sum of interior angles. If you are clear with these three concepts, then it's very easy to proceed. And one more thing, that is all of you know, still I am giving reminding. ABC be a triangle in which this is angle theta, this is your perpendicular, this is base, this is hypotenuse. Then what you will write your tan theta? Tan theta equal to P by B, perpendicular by base. Clear? Now based on these four things only, this derivation will occur. So here we are going to prove the Snell's law. Snell's law is applicable for a refraction. I already mentioned the point. What is that? If theta angle is small, then sin theta becomes theta. Here the assumption is nothing but your angle of incident and angle of refraction both are very small. So first what we have to write? According to Snell's law, your N1 sin I equal to N2 sin R, as the angle of incidence and angle of refractions are very very small. So we can write it as N1I equal to N2R. This what we are going to prove. Now let us see how the way you need to start. First you have to consider your angle I. So angle I, if I consider my triangle OMC, for the triangle, this I angle is exterior angle, that is nothing but which angle? So your I angle equal to MON angle plus the another angle is nothing but your MCN angle. MCN angle. Clear? Now what is my MON angle is? I have to apply the triangle rule. That is tan MON angle equal to, I already told, perpendicular by base. Perpendicular is MN. So MN by what is your base? Base is ON. One more thing, this is your object. So from the object to this distance, see, one more important point I am telling you. Here what is the exact point of crossing for your spherical surface and what's the perpendicular you draw? This distance is very very small, so hence it is negligible. You are assuming that the end point, both the points are merging, right? So you are writing MN by ON. Now what is ON? Is nothing but your object distance. And here also you can add one more point. If this is your origin, this is your plus X, this is your minus X, this is your normal coordinate, same also applicable here. Wherever your spherical surface, imagine that as the origin. So from that point your left will be positive, left will be negative, right will be positive. So left is negative. So what I'll write? MN. So MN divided by, what is my ON? Is nothing but minus U, because it is towards the left. Clear? Similarly, now I already mentioned, if theta is small, tan theta also theta, can I write it as now MON angle equal to MN by minus U over first part? Now coming to second, MCN. Similarly, if you write tan MCN angle, then what you will write? In the triangle MCN, MCN angle is what? Perpendicular by base. Perpendicular is MN divided by, what is base? Is NC. What is that? Radius of curvature. It is towards, from the center towards right axis, so plus R. Tan theta, theta value is small, so directly we can write as MCN angle equal to MN by R. This is nothing but your second equation. You can use this 1 and 2 here, MON, MCN. So what you will get now? Your I value, I equal to, this is MN by minus U plus MN by R. Clear? What you do? MN is common, take MN out. 1 by R minus 1 by U. This is your I. I think it's clear. What you are getting? Your I equal to MN common 1 by R minus 1 by U. So your LHS part, you got it over. Now let us see the right side, that is your R angle of refraction. So in order to find angle of refraction, now I think it's clear to all of you. Can I rub it? So now, in order to derive this, your angle of refraction, you consider this angle MNC. So in triangle MNC, what is the interior angle? These two, can I mention it as these two angles? Which one? R angle and this I angle is nothing but this exterior angle. So your R angle plus MIN angle equal to, these two angle equal to MCN angle. check these two interior angle equal to exterior angle. Now what is my R angle is nothing but MCN angle minus MIN angle. Now what is MCN angle? Already we got it, MCN angle. That is MN by R. So this is MN by R minus what is MIN angle? You can apply your directly tan P by B. P is nothing but MN by NI. What is this NI? Nothing but your image distance, that is B. Where it is forming? Towards right, so plus B. So what will write? Tan MN by NI. So MN by R minus tan MN by NI is plus B. Take your MN common, otherwise write first MN by R. I already mentioned, if angle theta is small, then tan theta becomes theta. So it is now becomes MN by V. Take MN common. So what you are getting is 1 by R minus 1 by V. Clear, this is your angle R. So from this important, your you can mention it as star mark 1. This is your star mark 2. Or you can mention it as 1, 2. This is 3 and 4. From equation 3 and 4, you have to justify this equation. What is that? N1i equal to N2r. So, N1 multiply with i. What is the value of i? Mn colon to 1 by r minus 1 by u. Clear? This is your N1i1 equal to N2r. So, N2. What is my r? Mn whole into 1 by R minus 1 by V. Now see, MN, MN common in both sides. Multiplication factor get cancelled. So now what is remaining? N1 by R minus N1 by U equal to N2 by R minus N2 by V. Now what you do? This R is common. Take it to one side. So what you will write? Take it to right side. Now it is minus N1 by U. Take this to this side. So plus N2 by V equal to N2 by R minus N1 by R. So here can you write it as N2 by V minus N1 by U equal to N2 minus N1 by R. This is nothing but your relationship between your image distance, object distance, N1, N2 refractive index, and R is the radius of curvature. This is the derivation which is highly important. If you have clear concept of this derivation, then directly the lens maker's formula we are going to substitute it. Mostly in board exams they ask lens maker's formula. Students omit this part. Without understanding this part, they directly try to attack that derivation. That's what they are always in confusion. So my request to all of you is, first have this clarity how you are getting this is nothing but application of Snell's law. Then after that some trigonometric substitution. If you are following that and normal coordinate, x axis right side will be positive, left side it will be negative. Same is applicable for your spherical surface reflection, refraction always for finding the image distance and object distance. So N2 is the refractive index of the second medium. V is the image distance, N1 is the refractive index of first medium, U is the object distance, similarly N2, N1, R is nothing but radius of curvature. Taking care of these notations, you should proceed. Okay students, in my next video, I will upload about the lens maker's formula. Take care.